Hey everyone, what is going on? So we are doing more Rainbow Cup battles. We don't have a lot of battles in this video, we have a few. But anyway, Jokes wanted me to leave his Twitter. He just created a Twitter, so if you want to go ahead and follow him, it will be in the description down below. You can give him a follow. He was actually thinking of doing PvP content videos, but he doesn't have, like, you know, a microphone and whatnot, and he doesn't know how to get started. So if we ever do get him started, I'll link his channel and let you guys know about that. But let me know if you want him to get started on his own videos, so you can have his perspective from some of the battles. That would be pretty cool, wouldn't it? I've been trying to convince him to give it a shot. Why not, you know? So he's a really good competitor, and yeah, that'd be really awesome. But yeah, check his Twitter. Give him a follow down below. I know he was adding a bunch of you guys, but I think he's since run out of room. I could be wrong about that. But either way, yeah, definitely go give him a follow at the very least anyway. And you can communicate, you know, if you want and whatnot. He's very big into the PvP scene. But anyway, for this video, just doing, as I said, a few battles. I don't know how many are in here. Maybe we have, I don't know, 5, 6, something like that. Decent amount of battles. I'm not doing or using anything in particular this video. We're just using some Pokemon that I like using. For this particular battle, it's basically over. You know, I have a Charizard against his Lantern, and Thunderbolt is just going to easily knock out Charizard. So we do take the loss just fine, you know. Not the win that time, we do lose that battle, but that's okay. For this match, we do begin with Lantern, and he begins with his Azumarill. Beautiful, shiny Azumarill. I want one. But yeah, good lead up from us. He's going to switch into Venusaur, and I'm going to pull the switch into Charizard. I decide to block this, and he bluffs with Frenzy Plant, so that's a really nice bluff on his end. And now he goes for a move, and I decide not to block. I'm like, even if it's Sludge Bomb, I don't want to waste my last shield, and it was. So that was a good call, or good bluff on his end. He definitely got me there. But still looking decent because, you know, his Pokemon is knocked out or whatnot. And so we have the lead in terms of that. Trying to get off another Blast Burn wasn't able to happen. I think both of us were having, like, a lot of glitches in these battles or whatnot. So that could be a part of it. I don't know. But, you know, anyway, we hit him with the Thunderbolt. He is going to go ahead and forfeit that last shield. So that was definitely good for us. We decided to take this, even if it's a play rough. Doesn't do too much, you know, maybe about 30%, 25%, so we'll take that. Getting off another Thunderbolt, he actually uses his Phyto Shield, so that is good for us. He brings in his Charizard. I'm going to switch into Quagsire, and I'm going to take this. I thought it was going to be a Blast Burn, as it was, but again, we're able to take that, trying to get to Stone Edge, and we actually do get to that Stone Edge before he's able to get off another Blast Burn, which would have knocked us out. Actually, I would have used the shield, but it would have taken our last shield. At this point, we're going to go ahead and take this move, which is going to be Ice Beam. That will be enough to knock us out, but we can come in with a Thunderbolt ready to go and knock out Azumarill. I figure I could block if he had another move ready to hit my Azumarill at that point, so we do go ahead and win that one. So nice match. We're going to jump into another one, beginning with Venusaur, and he leads with his Lantern. So another favorable matchup for us. We're just going to try and farm up that Pokemon. Of course, it's not going to happen, so we're going to switch right into Charizard. And this is where Fortress loses against Charizard. I mean, at the same time, Beedrill would lose to Charizard, so it's not that Beedrill's better or anything. In fact, Fortress probably is, but, you know, it's just a bug type. It's just going to easily lose to Fire Pokemon. But we do get off a Blast Burn, doing a good amount of damage. I mean, Blast Burn is just so powerful, isn't it? It does a lot of damage, so we'll go ahead and use those Blast Burns. He even had to shield that. That wouldn't have knocked it out, but it would have come very close. So, yeah. Anyway, at least Blast Burn is able to take his last shield. We bring in Venusaur. I ran down the clock just a little bit. And taking this Hydro Pump. Hydro Pump is such a powerful move, so does a lot of damage to us. I use Frenzy Plant. I don't farm it up because I knew a Thunderbolt at that range could have knocked me out, and I didn't want to risk him, you know, getting to a charge move. So that's why I used that Frenzy Plant immediately. And right now, he's going to go ahead and get off his move. Whatever it was would have taken me out, so I decided to use the shield. Getting off the Sludge Bomb against his Venusaur, which will do a lot of damage. Look how much that did to that Venusaur. So, poor Venusaur. No, I'm just kidding. But this, we definitely have to block out this Sludge Bomb. Sludge Bomb, Frenzy Plant would have done a lot of damage. He actually gets off another one. This is actually a Frenzy Plant. Does a lot of damage. I thought we were actually going to lose that. I mean, we came very close just because of how powerful Frenzy Plant is. So, yeah, we're able to win with that Ice Beam, but it was a very close match. So, another fine game. But we do go ahead and take it. So we're going to jump into yet another match. And it is currently pouring outside, guys. It's raining. It's lightning. It's thundering. You know, it's really coming down outside. Weather's not so good. But for this match, we begin with Kingdra. He does begin with his Venusaur. Going to go ahead and block that Frenzy Plant. Otherwise, that would have more than likely knocked out Kingdra at that range, and we'll be able to take his shield, one of his shields. I do go ahead and block this Frenzy Plant because I figured I'd be able to knock him out with Dragon Breath, but he actually pulls a nice switch into his Lantern, but we're still doing a decent amount of damage to Lantern before it gets to Thunderbolt, so I'll take that, and we're able to bring in Venusaur, which can farm up his Lantern a little bit. Well, we have to farm it up at this point because we're out of shields. I decided to farm it up, and then at the last minute, I decided to go for a Frenzy Plant because I wanted to knock out his Lantern before he was able to get off another charge move. So we farmed up enough for two Frenzy Plants, so able to take his last shield, and then we actually have another Frenzy Plant ready to go. So almost three Frenzy Plants we charged up on that Lantern, so I'll definitely take that. And his final Pokemon is that Quagsire, so we're able to get to yet another Frenzy Plant. So Venusaur, the MVP. Maybe I'll make this video about Venusaur, although Venusaur wasn't in every battle, I don't think. I don't know, I wasn't sure what to make this video, but I guess it might be about Venusaur, because Venusaur with that Sludge Bomb really coming in clutch. You know, I've used Meganium before. I like Meganium. I think Venusaur is a little bit better. But either way, we have Kingdra against his Lantern. Gonna go ahead and pull this first switch. Probably not a good idea because he's able to switch into Fortress, so I would say that was a mistake. If you don't have to, you shouldn't switch first. I don't like switching first. I don't know why I did it. Probably because I wanted to save Kingdra or whatnot, but now that cost us Venusaur, so Venusaur helped us the last battle, not so much in this one. We do bring out that Charizard, which is going to be able to make quick work of Fortress, but unfortunately he has Switch Initiative right now, and he's going to bring in Quagsire, which is going to do good against us. You know, we get over Blast Burn, I'll take that damage. Bringing in Kingdra, he pulls the Switch into his Lantern. I'm going to go ahead and block this Thunderbolt, just because we want to be able to get to Outrage. Now, I figured he would block this Outrage, which he does. He does go ahead and block that. That, I'm pretty sure, would have knocked out. Either that or it would have come very close. I should have blocked that Thunderbolt. It didn't knock us out. It came super close. And then if we did block it, we would have been able to finish him off with our Dragon Breath, I believe. Or maybe not. I don't know. I don't know, guys. But I feel like I should have blocked that. But either way, Charizard is going to go ahead and block that Lantern. And then his final Pokemon is going to be that Quagsire. We do get off a Dragon Claw, and he's going to go ahead and use his last shield, and then he hits it with Stone Edge. So, yeah, he's able to knock us out. I feel like that first switch shouldn't have happened. Maybe it would have switched the tide of battle. I don't know. Maybe it wouldn't have. But either way, that was a good game. You know, you play to learn. So for this one, we're going to begin with Raikou, and he's going to begin with his Beedrill. By the way, guys, this week I plan on releasing a video as to how and why I chose the 6 Pokemon I plan on using for my final team in the actual tournament. So that video I plan on releasing this week, so definitely check it out, or check out all the videos this week. But yeah, anyway, we have Raikou using a Wild Charge right now. He's going to go ahead and block that, so we take both of his shields. He gets off another move. I decide to block this. Even an Aerial Ace would knock us out, and then he switches into Lantern. So I go for the Shadow Ball. I actually go for the Shadow Ball immediately upon his switch, so he caught me off guard there. I wasn't able to go for the Wild Charge, and unfortunately we were not able to get off that other Wild Charge because he used that Thunderbolt. If he didn't use a Thunderbolt, we would have gotten that off, but that's okay. We bring in Venusaur. I decided to farm up Lantern. I mean, Hydro Pump would do a lot of damage, but it's still worth farming up Lantern. We'll just take all that damage in, and then he brings in, what does he bring in? We'll see. We will see what he brings in. I think he brings in Beedrill. Okay, I thought he brought in something else, but no, I guess it's Beedrill. I should have went for the Sludge Bomb. I did not. And then he pulls the switch into his Azumel. And I go for the Frenzy Plant just to do a lot of damage onto it. And then I'm going to charge up on this Azumel, or at least try to. But he's going to be able to get off the Ice Beam and knock us out. And then we bring out Charizard. Grinding up a little bit on Charizard. I figured it wasn't worth using our moves on Charizard. I needed to be able to knock out this Beedrill, so we charge up energy with Charizard, And yeah, we have enough for a blast burn, so I'm just clicking on blast burn as fast as I can because I don't know if he's at an aerial ace, and if he was, that would have knocked us out. But either way, we go ahead and take that game. And yeah, that's gonna be it for this one, guys. See you in the next video. Have a good day. Bye. Thank you so much for watching my latest video. Please like, comment, and subscribe, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter. If you like this video, click on one of the links to check out another one of my videos that you'll probably enjoy.